their team to victory out on that field. It's Vail's Lions going up against Peterson's Vikings. Now we'll go down to Jim Nance and Phil Sims for this Week 3 matchup.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we're getting set for an NFC North matchup as we join you from Ford Field.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Bill Sims. It always gets ratcheted up, the intensity, that is, when you got a divisional matchup at your hands like we do today.
You know, Jim, when you talk about divisional matchups, the coaches all week long keep telling the football team, this is like two games in one. Why? Because you're playing a division team. It's a rival. You've built your team to win the division. This is going to be great to watch.
And Sam Martin is set now to kick it away. The Vikings are back deep, ready to return the kickoff. With that kick, we're underway. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Bridgewater's coming off a week where he had a quarterback rating that hovered in the 140 range. So he should be feeling very confident here today. From the 22. Peterson, right side. And Lawson's in on the tackle. That's a nice, powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Now, Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here, but, you know, somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense is going to have to put some weights in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle.
Still on his feet. And he's tackled down after picking up the first.
It's always a chess match early in the game to see what your opponent is going to do. Good run that time by the offense. They pick up good yards. Maybe the defense will have to start crowding the line of scrimmage more.
The Lions defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. And incomplete. Here's a look at the Vikings offense. This is an efficient group. Last week, turning the football over just once.
Dagger! Dagger! Right lane! Right lane! Dagger! Dagger! Good! Right lane! Right lane! Four! Four!
The quarterback. He's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Can't hold on here as it goes incomplete. Here's the Lions defense. They know they need to force turnovers today, coming off a game in which they had no takeaways. The Vikings now facing third down. A week ago, they were up to the challenge in these spots. The Vikings snap it at the 36. And it's knocked down.
Put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
Looking to make a difference. Gain Vikings 19. The first overall selection in the 2009 draft by way of the University of Georgia, quarterback Matthew Stafford. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. The Lions all bunched up here as they get set at the line. The Lions snap it at the 36. Joint Bell has the reception.
What's the old expression? Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Jim. It also gives them a chance for three more downs.
The Vikings with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Still not taken down. Gains 12.
You want to be a running back in the NFL, I'll say this. You better be able to break some tackles. We saw multiple tackles broken that time. Good job.
Snap it at the 41. Griffin's all over that offense and brings him down.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
The Vikings with a nickel look here on defense. The Lions will take the snap from the 45. Looking at every option. Is it caught? Yes, the offense has the ball. And now let's take a look at the Lions offense. A coach's dream a week ago as this team never turned over the football once. Now looking at third down. Stafford standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Stands in the pocket. Johnson's got it. First down. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
And he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
The catch is made. Detroit in the end zone. Stafford's now got five touchdown passes on the season.
Well, as a rookie in the NFL, you're just happy to be in the league, making money, doing what you love to do, and that's play football. But how about that? When you get in position and you score your first NFL touchdown.
The Lions lining up for the point after. Inside of the uprights. The Vikings are ready to return the kickoff. He's got a chance to return this one. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Vikings stalled on their last drive, forced a punt. So now the offense comes back out onto the field.
Yeah, they're coming back out. They lack confidence, and I understand why. They came out, couldn't get anything done. The defense was flying around, making the plays. They got to change the tempo of this game.
The Lions defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. The Vikings take it from the 23. Good for only a yard.
Peterson's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go.
Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Second down following the run. Complete to Wallace. Picks up about five.
The Vikings that time, they can't get big yards, but the throw and catch picks up a few, and his third down's much easier with this situation.
The Vikings have it at the 29. Wallace on the receiving end. And a flag is down.
Illegal block in the back. Offense.
It's an illegal block in the back, and they now will be backed up some yardage.
Yes, always remember as a blocker, you need to get your head in front of the defender, and you got to get your front shoulder in front also to make it legal.
First down at the 34. Peterson's got the toss, secures the football, and they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Peterson's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
Bridgewater will have it in the pistol. The quarterback motions the wide receiver. First and 10. And he knocks the ball out of his hands. Second down after the incompletion. Incomplete.
On the offensive side, if it's third and long, there's very few plays that you have that are going to pick this up. So be careful in a situation like this.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
That's his first reception today.
Well, if you want to be a good play-action pass team, it's always nice to have a good running game. Make the defense dig in and try to stop your run. When they do that, you fool them. You fake it, you throw it down the field. That's about as easy as it gets.
The Vikings have it at the 34. Throws the pass. But can't connect on the short throw. Coming to the line at the 34. The Vikings have it at the 34. And the pass is complete to Wallace. Not able to get away from Tulloch that time.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches, running these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
The Vikings have it at the 29. Johnson with the grab.
Don't see enough of this in the NFL anymore, the out route. Everybody's afraid to throw it. They want all those little safe dink and dunks inside. But that is a nice throw and catch by the quarterback and wide receiver.
That will bring us to the end of the first quarter here in Detroit, and we'll return in a moment for the start of the second quarter. The second quarter is underway with this snap. Over the line, touchdown. And it didn't take long for them to get this game right back to even here in the second quarter.
Yeah, that was a nice drive on the offensive side. That makes you feel good, and you just to execute so many plays and find a way to get down there and score a touchdown.
Got a tie game here now, and what's been a good one so far. The score's 7-7. The Lions are ready to receive the kick. Tate's going to test the coverage this time. And the tackle is made right around. The 26-yard line. The Vikings defense comes onto the field after surrendering a touchdown on the last drive.
Well, they're hoping for better results. No question about that, Jim. They got to come out. They got to hustle. There was not enough hustle last time. And the number one key for all defensive teams is play hard.
Way to call them out there, partner.
Hey, that's what I'm doing.
Out of the eye, it's Bell. Able to take the football out to the 28-yard line.
Bell's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
After running it, it's second down. Bell's handed the football. He's tackled right at the 31.
Bell is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
Third down. Stafford in shotgun formation. Secures it with two hands.
That's a really good throw and catch, and they get the first down, Jim. That's what you want to do. Pick up that first down. Now you give your offense three more opportunities.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Keeps churning ahead, charging ahead. Waynes is the one who made the big stop. The Lions still tied up right now, but when you take a look at the running game, it has not been a big part of it for them. Bell's been shut down from the get-go.
Run game has been rough, and that's an understatement. I just say this to the offense. Start throwing the football. Loosen this defense up, and once you loosen them up, then you can run the football.
Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Arm strength is a nice thing to have when the window of opportunity is very small. Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
Stafford's now completed four in a row. Ball at the 47. Stafford's lined up. Two tight ends set. He's got a little bit of daylight here. Griffin's there to make the tackle.
Nice.
That time, when you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job on the offensive line.
Second down and three following that nice run. Stafford has everybody split out wide for this snap. Stafford's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. Johnson's got it, and a first.
My gosh, the wide receivers in the NFL now, it's incredible. It's not that you have one. Every team has two and three, and some have four. Good job that time by him hauling in that pass.
Scrimmage, the 25-yard line.
The Lions will take the snap from the 25. Catches the ball on the sideline, but does not get both feet down. Coming up, second down.
Look at that. Everybody at the line of scrimmage, the defense showing a blitz.
And a flag comes out.
Encroachment, defense. Still second down.
The Lions now inside the 20. A week ago, they converted time and time again inside the red zone.
Second down and five.
Bells taking the handoff.
You're running back in this league and you pick up first downs. If you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
formation huddle at the 14-yard line.
First and 10. Bell's going to take the handoff now. And that'll be a gain of about 2.
Bell's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Mounting a serious drive. The Vikings lined up in the nickel. Second down and 7. They'll run it with him again. Stiff arms to stay on his feet. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course it'll be a touchdown.
Kendricks all over the ball carrier. This will be the offense's 12th play of the drive. 2-minute warning looms, and this may be the last play before it hits. Second and goal from the 6. Minute warning. First half winding down as we return from the 2-minute warning. The Vikings defense now is going to go nickel. Third and goal at the 6. Scans the field. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown. They have the lead now here late in the second thanks to that touchdown, and they should have it, in fact, when we go to the intermission.
Oh, now you see in the future, huh? So you know those things. I'm just kidding, of course, Jim. Like to have a little fun with you every once in a while. But, hey, nice drive by the offense. That puts them in a great frame of mind going into halftime here soon.
Go now to Danielle Bellini, who has an injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a Vikings official. They wouldn't specifically say what the injury was, other than it's an upper body injury that won't stop him from returning. Back to you.
Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Ezekiel Ansah readying himself for this next possession. He's been the leader for them in what's been a terrific defensive effort up to this point, partner.
And you know what he does? He brings energy to the defense. There's no question about that. And I love the way he plays. It just rubs off on all of his teammates.
Incomplete. Almost going in the other direction. Second down following that incompletion. Makes the reception.
Nice job that time by the runner. Gets out of bounds after the play. You got under 2 minutes, and you need to stop the clock, so he gets it done.
First down here after the completion. They're going back up top. And Wallace got the catch and the first.
Well, the corner route. Some people call it the corner route. They call it a flag, run to the flag of the end zone, or a 7 route. Odd numbers break out. That time we see a nice route by the receiver and a good throw by the quarterback.
Bridgewater's completion percentage, 50% on the day. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day. The Vikings will take the snap from the 30. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
Situations you go over so many times in practice and training camp. Know what's going on the offensive side, how to preserve time. Good job that time by the offensive player. Get out of bounds and giving his team more chances to get it done here in the first half.
Staying with the passing game on first down. Reaches out and snatches it, and he'll step out. Bridgewater's the injured player, and we'll take a break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second down coming up. That defensive front looks impenetrable here on the goal line. Peterson will get it on the toss. Six for the Vikings. Finding the end zone for the second time. Boy, things suddenly feel a lot different as that touchdown ties things, Phil, right before the intermission.
Oh, yeah, it just changes everything. It puts one team in a funk because they let the other team tie it up. And, of course, when you're the team that's behind and you score that touchdown to tie it up before halftime, man, that makes you feel great.
Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has the injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a Vikings official. The injury is minor, so he's been cleared by the doctors. That means he should make his way back onto the field soon enough. Back to you.
The Vikings ready here for the kickoff. And this will be coming out to the 20 as he thinks better of running it out of the end zone this time. The Lions head back onto the field with their offense. We're going to see if they can keep the scoring onslaught going as we've seen touchdowns on consecutive possessions here, Phil.
Jim, these teams are so hot. And when you're hot like this on the offensive side, you just look at the coach and say, keep sending them in because we're going to make them work.
Scanning the field. Take the target with the catch. The Lions are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. First down, offense readying for the snap. Matthew Stafford from the shotgun. Bell with the grab. Shakes off the hit. And that's Robeson in on the stop. The Lions elect to take a timeout here before the second down snap. Ready to play after calling a timeout. That pass play picked up only four. Second down and six coming up. Stafford from the gun. Bell with the reception. That's a gain of 10.
Well, when there's under 2 minutes to go, good job by the offensive ball carrier that time. He knows he can get no more yards. He steps out of bounds to stop the clock.
Stafford has now completed four in a row. To Ebron. Gets about 4 yards that time. The Lions signal for the timeout, and they have none remaining. So they complete one, and still it's second down. Bell is in the backfield. The ball is jarred loose.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Bell lined up as the single back. Third down and six. Surveys. But it falls incomplete.
Sometimes you wonder how can they drop passes in the NFL, college football, or high school, because the gloves these receivers wear, they are magnificent when it comes to helping you catch the football. So that's a big drop. When you get open, you got to make the catch.
Looking at every option. The first half is in the books, and we're tied, each defense matching one another play for play. Larry Ridley is coming up next. Ford Field is the site of today's game. Jim Nance once again sitting side by side with Phil Simms for the call as we get set for the third quarter. Vikings now ready to kick the football down the field. We're underway in the second half now. Which team will be able to open up a lead here? Stafford will lead his offense back onto the field here as this goes for a touchback. The Lions offense will try to set the pace early here in the second half with this game tied, Phil.
Yeah, they're going to try to set the pace, but look, on the other side, this defense is aggressive. It's tough. I think the defense is going to get after them and maybe cause a turnover right here.
Second half gets rolling now as he takes the snap. Robeson in on the stop.
Lions have been awesome today on first down. That time it's a nice play design. They throw the football, picks up solid yards. Second and short. Boy, that's what every offense likes to be in.
Following that completion, second and short. Bell is in the backfield.
Corners down the NFL, they're asked to do so many things. Stop the run, cover guys in zone, cover them in man-to-man coverage. And how about this blitz at time by the corner? Gets to the quarterback and takes him down for the sack.
Third down on the way. Stafford's back in shotgun formation. Almost intercepted that time. Defense was the order of the first half, Phil Simms, and it's hard to even see a scenario where that doesn't continue.
I think we got a trend going here. Here we are in the third quarter, and the offenses are still locked up, can't do anything. I don't care. I like this. Defenses rule today.
This punt will be returned. And they bring him down at the 33-yard line. First down at the 33. Peterson's going to receive the toss. He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
Second and short following the run. The Lions defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. They'll go ground. They are in on Peterson.
Peterson's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
Now first and 10. Charles Johnson with the catch. Gets about 9 on the play.
Vikings coaching staff has done a good job of mixing things up today on first down. The pass catches the defense off guard. They pick up solid yards. Now it's second and short.
Tiger! Tiger!
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Rudolph's there to catch the ball that had a lot of heat on it.
I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
Bridgewater's completed his last six passes.
Teams in the NFL spend about 30, 40% of their time all week long practicing plays in the red zone. So there's a lot they can do here. Let's see if they come up with something that works.
That's reception number two for him.
Nice job that time by the offense getting the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm, because you've got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
Bridgewater's completion percentage, 60% on the day. First and goal. They'll run it here. And a flag is down.
Holding offense.
That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
Give this secondary credit. This passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The Lions with a nickel look here on defense. Second down and a long way to go. McGee's able to read that play and make the hit.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Forever. And Wallace, Minnesota, in for the score. And that touchdown puts them in a very good position, holding the lead with this game getting ready to enter its final stages.
Yeah, you know what? You put the pressure on the defense. Let's go out there and do their job. Don't get timid. Man, call aggressive plays, and you got to tell your defensive players, run and gang tackle the person with the football.
Tate's going to start his return. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The Vikings defense, last time out there, said, you know what, we're in the three and out business.
The great late Charlie Jones would have said that was spectacular. And that's what they looked like on that last drive. They dominated in every aspect.
You had to love Charlie Jones.
Oh, and he was the best.
The Lions have it at the 29. Bell up the middle. And he's able to get out to the 34-yard line.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt, when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
And it's now second down and five after running it on first down. Stafford's pass will be incomplete this time.
There are a lot of ways to attack cover, too. You can go deep down the middle where neither the safeties are, or if a linebacker covers somebody deep down the middle, then throw it short underneath the defense.
Third and five following the incompletion. Stafford in shotgun formation. And on the mark with Golden Tate.
Look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Stafford's completion percentage, 60% on the day.
First down and 10.
Bell's got it on the handle. Met by Barr that time.
The Lions have continued to try to find a rhythm on the ground. Bell's coming off a down week, and he's on his way to another one, it appears.
Jim, I'm not going to blame the running back. The offensive line has to give him a chance. But listen, let's turn it around to the other side. Let's give the defense a little credit.
Bell is in the backfield. The Lions snap it at the 41. Tate's got it on a pass that had some heat.
Did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and you know you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Here's the handoff. Bell's marked down after a gain of 4.
Bell's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Breaking huddle at the 35-yard line.
Second down and 6.
Gets it again. Cody's all over that offense and brings him down.
The Lions have the football as the fourth quarter gets started.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive.
The Vikings lined up in the nickel.
The final quarter begins with this snap.
Has the reception all alone. Tackles made.
That's another reception. Give him 2.
Lions just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
First and goal.
Bell's going to secure the handoff.
Oh, my gosh, it is the worst thing you can do on the offensive side. This drives coaches crazy. When you get down near the goal line, you run the football and you lose yards. That's just not being tough enough.
Second and goal from the 5. Ball is out. And it's a takeaway.
And he's brought to the ground.
The defense comes up with the big play, the hit, and the recovery of the football.
They sure did. They got so much speed on the defensive side, and that speed, when you think about it, it gets more people around the football. It helps you deliver the hit even harder, and that's why they got the turnover. Great job.
Toss to the outside. Peterson's met at the 16. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
Good job that time by the defense. They're down. It's in the fourth quarter. They are expecting the offense to run the football, and they stop it for a couple yards.
Second down here after that run play. Slashes to the left side.
They're going to run it on the toss.
Of running by Adrian Peterson.
Phil, today we've seen a running back who was putting up some big rushing totals.
Jim, sometimes I get tired of talking about the quarterbacks and wide receivers, how well they're doing. What a good change of pace to watch the game evolve around a running back. And man, this guy is taking advantage of those opportunities. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Wallace has the grab.
They take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
The Vikings, they never back off. That first down, they got a small lead here in the second half. What are they looking to do? They're looking to march this football down the field and score.
Bridgewater's completion percentage, 60% on the day.
First and 10. Handoff. Now cutting to the right side, looking for some open space.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
At the line of scrimmage, the 34. An extra tight end on the field for this one. First and 10. Flip to the outside. Running room. That's a gain of 8.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Vikings snap it at the 26. They are in the backfield in a hurry and will bring them down for a loss behind the line of scrimmage.
The Vikings offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? You run, loses yards. That's just a bad job of the offensive line.
The Vikings from the 27. Oh, and almost picked off that time.
That was a good call by the defensive coordinator. He called the right defensive play. The defender's in position and knocks down that third down throw.
The kick is good. An insurance field goal for them. Probably not enough time left to surrender this lead. They're gaining control of this one down to the finish.
Sometimes in this game, when you get a lead, it's not about trying to pour it on. It's about being smart. All that matters is winning. Find a way to get this game over with while you're still on top.
The Lions. Phil, what's the issue with this team? This offense specifically. 3 straight drives without a score.
Well, Jim, I'd say this. It's bad coaching. I just hate what they're trying to do on the offensive side. They're not putting their players in position to give them a chance to compete against this defense. They've got to change things up, give their offense a chance, and give these players a chance.
Nothing drives a coach crazier than a false start penalty.
False start offense.
Press coverage all the way. Stafford's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Stands in the pocket. Second down coming up. The Lions come to the line with a bunch set. Stafford's going to take it from the gun. And it's complete to Golden Tate. 6th catch today so far. The Lions still trail, but as we look at the passing numbers, it's hard to find much fault with them. Stafford's numbers, though, speak to a team that could be winning if other things like their defense were doing their part here, partner.
Well, yeah, that's right. The defense has got to hold their end up, but the offense, they've been very, very good. The quarterback has been accurate. He has been smart, and that always gives you a chance when your quarterback is playing that well.
Has the grab.
Well, when your team is behind, what do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense. Defense has crowded the line of scrimmage. They're trying to confuse the quarterback.
Now first and 10. Scans the field. Stafford over to Johnson. The Lions have been very good throwing the football today. Stafford's been efficient, he's been finding his targets, and he's getting it done.
He is showing why he's one of the better quarterbacks in the NFL. When you take his talent and you put along with it great decisions, you get something special on the field.
2 minutes to go in the second half. Just 2 minutes left of this one. We're back now for the end of the fourth quarter. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. First down at the 46. He'll throw it over the middle. Bell's brought down, but not until he gives his team a new set of downs. First down. Pressure on every snap now.
Good job by the offense going the hurry-up offense. You do this to get the plays in, but also you want to conserve the timeouts.
One team's running the football, the other is passing, but both are working with their game plans.
Yeah, they both are working. As you look down there on the field, one set of running backs are really happy. On the other side, the wide receiver group, they're really happy. So as long as you get it done, that's all that matters.
Second down and 10. And this goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle.
Well, I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third and long situation for the offense, to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
The Lions take it from the 33. He's got the catch. Gains 15. Now on first down. Every snap crucial the rest of the way.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up, get that football snap, conserve time, and most of all, conserve that timeout. Those are big down the stretch.
And that's a gain of 13. Third catch today so far. They'll go right to the hurry up. Won't use a timeout here. Touchdown, Detroit. That's his first touchdown catch of the season.
That's a wonderful catch by the receiver, getting his first touchdown of his rookie year and making that catch. That is the first of many to come for him.
Driving extra point is good. Stafford's going to have a tough time upstaging what he did on that scoring drive, passing for over 80 yards against a defense that had no answers for him. The Lions late in the game looking to get the ball back on the onside kick. The Lions will rely on their special teams here as they try to get the ball back with an onside kick. Everything hinged on them recovering that onside kick, and they failed to do so.
Well, Jim, when you're doing the onside kick, you really got to hope for that perfect bounce of the football. That time it did not happen. That's why they didn't recover.
You see the matchup at running back, and while only one side has really been able to count on that run game, it's still a very close game.
Yeah, it is, Jim. Close game here, and also that can happen when you talk about run games. They're going to go up and down. And if you're having trouble running the football, then change the direction of your offense. Do something else.
First down at the 42.
Wide to the left.
Peterson will get it on the toss. They'll mark him at the 29. The Lions will stop the clock here with this timeout, needing to preserve time. They're able to move the chains after that last run.
Force! Let's go!
Here's the quick toss. Got a big lane. What a run by Peterson. The Lions stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second.
Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
Takes the knee. The Lions will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point. Takes the knee. Okay, partner, it's still early in the season, but this team continues to stay unbeaten.
Yeah, when you're hot, Jim, take advantage of it. Keep it going, because the NFL season, it's like four seasons built into one. You go up and down. So when you're hot, trust it, believe in it, and try to keep it going.
Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.